up for a retired cop who's still in rehab. Let's hear from Mr. Ray W. Come on, let's hear it.
Thank you for coming. Guys my age, we don't hear that often. Not that funny. We're mostly about going. I'm up to five times a night, 10 times a day. The only thing gold about these years is my urine. I think my mother was clairvoyant. All you'll ever do in life is piss and moan. Piss and moan. Here I am. 50 Shades of Yellow. So recently I passed a milestone, which is kind of strange to me because I can barely walk a mile. And the stones I have, I guarantee I'm never going to pass. But anyway, 45 years ago, I enlisted in the military. Yes, thank you. And I interrupted my busy schedule of binge drinking and getting fired for jobs. So I joined the Navy thinking, you know, maybe I'd be safe in the Navy. I should have paid attention to geography. Vietnam has rivers. And on those rivers are little boats. And they're very close to shore, so but anyway, I made it back. And I learned some good skills that would re-acclimate me into society. Like, for instance, I can roll a perfect joint. The bad news is I had post-traumatic stress disorder. Good news, though, it qualified me immediately to join the police department. Where I'm immediately signed to the narcotic squad. NYPD, like a lot of departments, they are very specialized. Like NYPD has a cabaret unit, and then their intelligence unit, that's an oxymoron, have a hip-hop squad. Now you don't get assigned, you have to audition with an original rap song, and you gotta be able to name 20 rappers' baby mamas in the room. So we have a new mayor. I don't know what you think of him. Yeah. There's a little trouble with the snow. We couldn't get over that. Jesus Christ. But stop and frisk is a big topic here. It started back in the Dinkins administration. I think it was like an investigative tool. And then Giuliani came in. And it was stop, motherfucker. A little different take on it. And then you have Bloomberg. It was stop everybody. Although with the exception of probably 95% of the people in this room. So now you got de Blasio, right? Put the pendulum swing a little bit. Stop in the name of love. Before you break the law, think it over. All right, fellas, put the guns away. Try not to shoot each other on the way home. Thank you. My father is a chief inspector in the police department. We never got along. I'm human. He was German. The Germans are very special in a sadistic, psychotic kind of way. He used to say to me, it's either my way or my way. Or things like, hey asshole, why don't you get a haircut? I can't tell whether your hair is growing down from your head or up from your ass. Well, 45 years later, guess what? My hair is growing up from my ass out of my head. And falling out of my head, and growing out of my ears. My freaking back looks like a tumbleweed farm. Man. And I don't know if we have any seniors out there, but my freaking head is shrinking. My ears are growing every day. My nose is getting bigger. If it keeps up, I'm gonna look like Mr. Potato Head. It's unbelievable. And I hear these guys, you know, I'm 70 years old. I never felt better in my life. Really. What were you in, like a catastrophic accident when you were 6 years old and you're just recovering? Jesus Christ. But I am waging a personal war on getting old. I'm not really doing anything about it, I'm just complaining about it right now. But I was officially, I guess, designated an elderly person. I get on the subway, this guy wants to give me a seat. I didn't know whether to slap him or thank him. And just as I thought, nah, he just kind of waved him on, I get this, my back starts seizing up. This pain is like somebody stabbed me in the back. My left knee, I'm losing feeling. So now he actually gets up, he says, come on, you want a seat? I'm good, I'm good, I'm good. So the subway stops, I get off, I was like 50 miles from my own stop. And I crawl up onto the bench where I wept for about an hour. Hey, what about this old person smell? Anybody know about that? You're asking, right? Well, I'll tell you. Unless you're frozen, you are decomposing. It's the way it is. Get used to it. But it's not all bad getting old. For instance, your clothes, if you get old enough, your clothes come back in style. So the other day, I walk by this thrift shop and I decide to go in, right? So these dudes walk up to me. One guy named Macklemore, the other guy, Ryan Lewis, I don't know if you know that guy. So the Macklemore guy looks at me, looks at my coat, and he goes, this is fucking awesome. And I'm like, what? So he says, I want that jacket. I'm like, oh, fuck off, brother. So there's an old brother in the corner who looks up and said, damn, you're a cold-ass honky. I said, yeah, brother, you gotta be. It's hot out here. Let me tell you something. Getting old ain't no joke. The disrespect makes me choke. Before my family goes in mourning, let me issue you this warning. I'm an old man with a young plan, 65 man with a strong hand. No fear, son, got a big gun. Deep lines, gray hair, long life, wear and tear. It's the cover, not the book. Inside never comes. Three tours Vietnam. I crawled through shit up to here, but I could only smell the fear. I stared the reaper in the face, and someone else took my place. So you think hard before you leap. Still waters run deep. I'm an old man with a young plan. 65 man with a strong hand. You feel me?